If you are in your 12th standard and deciding which college to join for your graduation, then this video is for you because I'm going to be discussing how to decide onto your college for graduation. Covering all three factors that if you are looking at doing a professional course, if you're looking at doing a master's degree, and if you're looking to start your own business, then how do you decide onto which college to join? Do watch my video till the end because I have a lot of insider tips available. I'm Megha Bansali, Indian Qualified Chartered Accountant, ACCA, and a career counselor. I meet a lot of 12th standard students who are very much confused on what they should be doing, how they should decide a college, which course to pursue. Now, which course to pursue, I have already created a video. You can go check it out. Based on your career alignment, you can decide that. However, how to decide onto a college is what we will be discussing in this video. And guys, please do subscribe to my channel. Drop in a comment below on stating how you found the video or if there is any particular content on which you want us to make a video. Now to begin with, if you are doing a professional course, something like a CA, ACCA, CIMA, USCMA or an Indian CMA, then please look at a graduating course which is very light or a college which will keep you very light on your graduation level. Before that, guys, if you're doing a professional course, don't feel that it is not important to do a graduation. Do not do a correspondence. It has no value. And a graduation is very much mandatory. You're at 18, 19 years of age. Today, you will feel that I do not want to study ahead in life. But what after 10 years you want to study something ahead? Then your graduation will make a lot of difference. So please do a graduation irrespective of whatever you are doing. But if you're doing a professional course, then the deciding factor for your graduating college, first most important factor is the flexibility available. If you're doing a professional course, it demands a lot of time, lot of dedication, lot of studies. So that's why make sure your graduation is very flexible. You have a lot of relaxations in terms of attendance, submitting assignments, and a lot more things so that you can focus onto your professional degree. So the college should be very much flexible. There should be a lot of relaxation available. Second important factor that you can consider is what kind of assistance will be available for your professional course. Are there any institutional tie-ups from which you can take coaching? Are there any faculties which will help you provide coaching or classes if you're stuck at your professional degree? Are there any career counseling available at the degree? So kind of figure that out if there is any assistance available. Third important factor is definitely cost. How expensive would it be to join an integrated college versus how it would be if you're doing it individually? So please keep these factors in mind before deciding on which college to join if you're looking at a professional course. To give you my example, you know, I belong to Bangalore and I did my CA along with my BCom from Jain University. This is not any promotion, but because I'm an alumni of Jain University, I would like to talk about it. So I had a lot of relaxation, lot of flexibility available because I was pursuing my CA. So, you know, I had a lot of flexibility in terms of attendance, lot of relaxation in terms of assignments to be submitted. They also had a university, they also had an institutional tie-up where we could go do our coaching. Because we got all these facilities, you know, doing CA became a lot more easier. And my BCom also has value because Jain University is a good reputed university. So please consider these factors before deciding onto your college. Now moving on to second category of students who are looking at doing their masters, then if you belong to that category, the college that you're choosing or the university that you're choosing plays a very, very important role. Because when you're going to be applying for your masters, credits is all that matters. So all universities have different level of credit. If you're doing it from a good university and let's say that university is listed as a reputed university, you're going to get a lot more credits versus any other university. So consider this factor. Now, how do you figure out how much credits or how much valuation a university has? For this, you need to first figure out what are the colleges in which you want to apply for masters. To give you a simple example, let's say you're looking at London University. Just go to London University's site and see how they value credits or how they're going to give you credits for your graduation. and based on that you can decide which college you should join for your graduation. So credits play a very, very important role when you want to do masters. The second important factor that you should be considering are the placements, because whenever you're going to apply for your masters, your job experience is going to hold a lot of value. So please make sure your university has good placement opportunities, the package is very good, because that is where your ladder is going to begin with. So it is a very important factor. And also my recommendation, if you're looking at doing masters, please do it after 1 or 2 years of work experience. Again, so that you can get good credits and it will hold a lot of value when you're looking at your masters. So while you're doing your masters, or if you're deciding a college based on your masters, then it will really help you. Now moving on to the third category of students who want to start their business, then in that case, you can look at a college again which is a little more relaxed. Reason being, I would like you to start exploring at your graduate level, do a lot of internships so that you get idea of various fields of any business, preferably join any startup so you understand how to start up with things, how does marketing work, how does finance work, how does business development work. All these fields are very important to understand. And theoretically, they will be very different, and practically is going to be very different. So do an internship in different fields in any startup so that you get a good idea of how you should run your business, how processes should be set, what to do, what not to do. And it will really help you when you start your entrepreneurial journey. So I think these are factors which you can decide on how to join a graduating college. However, if you're still confused what you should be doing in life ahead, then my suggestion would be look at a college which has good credits plus which is a little bit relaxed, so that you get time to join a lot of internships, you get time to explore, and also if you want to apply for masters, you're going to get decent amount of credits. And yes, if you're confused, then another factor that you should be considering is what are the extracurricular activities available at the college, because definitely this also holds a lot of value, because it will help you explore your skills. Plus, if you're looking at a job, all these are really valued. What other than your knowledge or your books can you bring onto the table? So join a college which is giving you a lot of exposure, either in terms of internship or in terms of cultural activities, so that you get a flavor of everything, and then you can make a wise decision of what you want to do with your career. So these are basic factors that you should be deciding on which college you should be joining in. However, if you're confused, you require any kind of counseling, you can definitely reach out to me. I will be very happy to help you. And guys, please do subscribe to my channel, like my video, share it with all your peers who are in 12, who are confused and still deciding how to pursue their graduation. I'll be back with more such content. Till then, take care. See you all.